Number one, you should not get into a business because you don't want a boss. Like, I'm going to tell you, at some point, if you start a company, you will become a boss. And then at that moment, when your employees want to call in sick, when they don't want to listen to you, when they're irreliable, irresponsible, something goes wrong and they're customer facing and it looks bad on you, you'll start to blame your employees when really it's a lack of leadership. So if you have a 9-to-5 right now and you're trying to get away from your boss, my suggestion to you is, what can you learn from that boss? I've had some of the worst leaders. I can't tell you, hopefully they didn't join my challenge, but I've had some of the worst leaders and I've learned the most about leadership from those leaders. And it was kind of like, even when I was like 18, 20 years old, ooh, note to self, I did not like the way he just made me feel. Note to self, she is really not very professional. I would never act like that if I was a leader. So it's really important that if you have a normal job, if you hate your boss, you should be in training right now. This is like combat training for you to eventually become an entrepreneur, because everything that you see and don't like, at some point your employees will hate about you too. Okay, so that's number one. Number two, if you think that you're gonna start a job because you're just tired of the grind and you want flexibility, wrong reason to start, because that's when the grind actually begins. When your heart and soul gets poured into something, your finances, let's say you quit your job and now everything you have is relying on the stability or the success of this business, there is no flexibility, especially in the early stages. Like, you're gonna have to be flexible with problems. But I remember one of the things when we first started our business, I had a partner. Won't get into all that, but I don't know if you guys know, it was my husband's ex and the mother of my children, my stepkids, when we started the Cake Mamas. And very quickly we realized we were not on the same page. She wanted to start a business because she thought it would create freedom and flexibility. And I was like, yo, we're trying to grow a company. We're taking all the orders we can. And we can't go to weddings, and there's no parties on the weekends, and we can't go to bars on Thursdays and Friday nights. So if you're looking for flexibility, especially in the first few years of your business, I'm going to tell you that you're sadly uninformed. You're not going to have flexibility. You're going to be married to your business in the beginning stages. Next thing, if you think that it's a good idea to start a business because you love something, you're passionate about it, you make whatever it is you make, I'm going to tell you that, truth be told, I started my business because I loved creating art. I'm super creative. I love making things. I loved using my hands. I had a corporate career and I didn't get to do that. So when I started making cakes from home, it brought me life. Here's the thing. The moment you go into business, you have 8,000 other responsibilities that are more important than you actually making that product. So raise your hand if you understand what I'm saying. You're here on a call to learn about branding. Branding is not something that most people, especially in the passion or creative world, when you turn that passion into the thing that you make into a business, those people are traditionally not the best when it comes to, oh, I've got to really educate myself around branding, marketing, leadership, things like that. Therefore, this is why the name Starving Artist kind of bleeds into that. It's like a plague, right? If you have something creative that you make, there's this plague of, oh, you become a starving artist. It's because you're not educating yourself on the things that are actually important. So the number one I say to bakers or cake makers or photographers is, like, I get that you like it, but liking it's not enough to sustain all of the hard issues and hard times that you're going to go through to get this business off of the ground and make it profitable.